And this is a very important portion, this last one that I want to highlight. It just as he did before. And remember, we already prayed. You could be seated. I'm not going to be too long. We got to get right into prayer. But the title of my message is A New Prayer for a New Season. A new year. A fresh start, a fresh opportunity. Where God is getting ready. Where God is already doing something. Where we have already announced the new things that are taking place in the house. Brother Jose said it perfectly just a second ago. God is getting ready to do a new thing in the church. Hey, church, we see we're already switching up dates. We're getting ready to do, God is doing a new thing. And you know, as he does a new thing in the church, how many know he's going to do a new thing in your life? He's doing a new thing in ministries. He's doing a new thing in marriages. Come on, how many of us need a new thing in our marriage? You know, it's awesome because as we start the new year, we get to start fresh with fresh goals. 2022 was something else. It was a thing of the past. If you did not accomplish those goals, well, this year, God is doing something. He's doing something in the gang ministry. Let's get personal. He's doing something with your children. Something fresh. There's a praying parent. There's a praying father and mother in this room. Hallelujah. And because of those prayers, I don't know if you hear me, but God is getting ready to do something new. He's getting ready to do something new at your job. I believe that there's going to be promotions. Hallelujah. I believe that there's going to be business owners and homeowners this year. Come on, we got a whole 365 days to go. And in between those days, God is going to do something new. He is already doing it.
Ya lo está haciendo.
Days into the new year, 2023.
Días frescos del 2023.
God is already doing something fresh.
Dios ya está haciendo algo fresco.
He's doing something fresh within my life, I could tell you that.
Yo creo que está haciendo algo fresco en mi vida, te puedo decir.
So many other things that we can get into.
Y tanto que podemos entrar.
And I'm not sure, but this is a new season for me and you.
Pero es una temporada nueva para nosotros.
A new season that we're coming into.
Una temporada nueva que entramos.
And I decided to call it a season
y decidí hablar de esta temporada
because it's only the beginning of what God is doing.
Porque es el principio de lo que Dios está haciendo.
You know, as time goes by,
mientras pasa el tiempo,
God will eventually do,
Dios va a hacer,
or he will get us to accomplish the things that he's called us for as a church. And we can go back and forth about what the church is called to do and the prophecies over the church. If you don't know them, I suggest you get into them. Ask somebody on the front row. But right now there's no time. But just know that God is already fulfilling what he's called us to do. But at the same time, these things that God is getting ready to do can sometimes be frightening to come into. The unknown is always a scary thing to come up against. How many can agree?
You
know, when God begins to do a new thing, when God begins to call you out,
Dios te a llamar, a hacer algo nuevo,
when God begins to bring you into a new ministry,
te trae un nuevo,
new commitment,
nuevo
something new, something fresh, it can become a little bit scary.
Algo nuevo, algo fresco, puede ser
because we don't know how we're going to go about it or what's going to take place.
No qué va a pasar, o cómo va a
but
tomar
thank
lugar.
God that we've been taught to know, all I know is that God called me.
Pero
all I know is that God is going to do it.
Que sabemos que Dios lo va a hacer.
And as me and you get into this new season, I can surely say from personal experience, I don't know about you, but me, that God blesses me and everything behind me. My children. Isaiah 59:21. That same spirit that was upon our, that is upon our founder,
it's
going to be over the Joshua, the third wave, and our children. That was a good place to shout right there. Because as God calls you, as God brings you into this new year, as God begins to raise you up, do something in your marriage, in the church house, oh, you better believe that somebody is going to receive the blessing. Church, and I don't need it to be me, but I pray that my children and my children's children would receive that blessing. But it can be scary to get into these things sometimes. Y'all was talking the other day to my wife.
Yo estaba hablando con mi esposa.
And I want to read it as it is so that it could relate to all of us.
Y quiero leerlo como es para poder relatar.
The other night, and I told her how frightening a new season can be.
Yo le estaba comentando de cómo una temporada nueva puede ser temerosa.
Because of the things that God is getting ready to do.
Por lo que Dios está listando para hacer.
I can feel me personally,
yo personalmente puedo sentir,
at times doubt because of insecurities,
que puede venir la duda por inseguridades,
my lack of everything.
Mi falta de que, faltas en mí.
Sometimes that kind of stuff brings fear.
A veces trae temor eso.
The unknown, the lack of security,
de lo que no conocemos, de la inseguridad.
Overthinking the expectations,
el sobrepensar las expectativas.
Overthinking period,
o pensar, punto.
People, family, what they're going to think, what they're going to say,
gente, familia, lo que van a decir o pensar.
Past hurts and the fear of encountering those hurts once again,
o a lo mejor traumas que venimos cargando, si
as we get into this new season.
Entramos en la temporada nueva.
Maybe it's the lack of education,
a lo mejor es porque no tenemos educación.
Or the fact that I'm not the best communicator,
o a veces porque no puedo comunicar.
Or that I'm not good with passing tests and doing this and doing that. I don't know if you could relate to me, man, but all those things, they begin to get the best of me sometimes. Coming into something that I don't know what it's going to be like later on. Unsurety, the lack of security in my life. All I want to do is I want to accomplish and be successful, but sometimes that giant, it looks way too big for me.
Pero a veces ese gigante se ve demasiado
grande. I'm going to be honest, sometimes I come back like the 10.
Y a veces yo regreso como los 10.
And I say, you know what, I look like a grasshopper.
Y digo, yo me veo como un chapulín comparado.
Going over there. But that's why I thank God for a church.
Pero yo le doy gracias a la iglesia.
That's why I thank God for a leader.
Por los líderes.
That's why I thank God for what he's doing here, because he reminds me
por lo que Dios está haciendo,
that you are not the 10, but you are the 2.
Que no eres de parte de
and
los
you
got to
come
dos.
Back. Because what God is doing,
por lo que Dios está haciendo,
I said, because what God is doing
por lo que Dios está haciendo,
is something way beyond you.
Es algo más allá de ti.
And you don't have to worry about it.
No tienes que preocuparte de
because ello. God is going to take care of you.
Porque Dios te va a cuidar.
Watch this right here.
Miren esto.
This is what she reminded me of.
Y esto me recordó.
And this is so simple, it's just going to refresh you.
Y es tan simple, nos va a refrescar.
She said, it's just going to take more prayer.
Solamente va a tomar más oración.
Because you know what prayer does?
Porque sabe lo que hace la oración?
It draws us closer to God.
Nos acerca más a Dios.
We become one with him.
Nos hacemos uno con él.
Another thing that it does is it brings comfort and peace.
Trae consuelo y
paz. I don't know about you, but I need comfort and peace
yo
sometimes.
No sé ustedes, pero ocupo consuelo y paz a veces.
I need to know that God is with me.
Tengo que saber que Dios está conmigo.
But how can I feel that security if I don't even spend time with him?
Pero ¿cómo voy a sentir seguridad si no paso tiempo con él?
How can I know for a fact that God is with me?
¿Cómo puedo saber por hecho concreto que está conmigo?
If I don't take the time to get close to
him. Si no tomo el tiempo para acercarme.
Security, God's favor. What about God's favor?
El favor de Dios.
You're coming into a new job, let's say.
Entras a un trabajo, por
man, you're coming in to maybe speak to some leaders or coming into something new that God is doing. Maybe you're out to go try to buy a house, I don't know.
O estás a punto de comprar tu hogar,
or
una
rent
casa.
A place, I don't know, get a new car off the lot.
Rentar una casa o un carro nuevo,
or you saved
yo.
Up a little bit of cash, you want to buy a new car.
O guardaste dinero y quieres debes gastar en ello.
We need God's favor for all that.
Ocupamos el favor de Dios para eso también.
And that's what prayer does.
Y eso es lo que hace la oración.
Strength and clarity. That's another one right there.
Fortaleza y claridad.
Strength and clarity is what prayer does for me.
Fortaleza y claridad es lo que
because sometimes
para
in the midst of the battle,
porque a veces en medio de la batalla,
we can get all foggy.
Se puede, poner nublado la
the
cosa.
Enemy will, I'm going to challenge you, the enemy will put up a smoke screen.
El enemigo va a poner una nube de humo.
He got it, that's right. He will put up a smoke screen to try to distract us and steer us away from that very thing that God is trying to do in our lives. He says, oh no, the church is growing. It doubled in numbers in just a few months.
Oh, la iglesia está creciendo, está dobleteando números.
Man, I need to take out so and so.
Tengo que llevarme fulano de tal.
I need to distract them. There's something that I need to do.
Voy a distraerlo. Tengo que hacer algo.
But prayer.
Pero la oración.
I said prayer.
La oración
gives us clarity.
Es lo que da claridad.
It gives us revelation.
Nos da revelación.
It gives us understanding and wisdom. It gives us strength.
Nos da fortaleza.
How many of us need that?
¿Cuántos ocupamos eso?
See, the key for Daniel,
y la llave para Daniel
was that Daniel stood his ground in the midst of the trial.
Es que Daniel se tomó su lugar en el medio de la tribulación.
He did what he knew to do best.
Hizo lo que sabía hacer mejor.
And just look at what God did for him.
Y mira lo que Dios hizo para él.
Because it is God who's going to do it through you,
es
might I remind
Dios
you.
Iba a hacerlo por medio de él.
Not you who will make it happen.
No, tú que lo va a hacer pasar.
Because we already tried all that.
Porque ya intentamos eso.
And let me ask you tonight.
Y te digo esta noche,
how well did that go?
¿Qué también te tomó eso?
When you tried doing things on your own.
Cuando quisiste hacer por tu propia cuenta.
We leaned on our own understanding.
Y te acercaste a tu propio entendimiento.
We did things the way we thought it was best.
Lo hiciste a tu manera, lo que pensabas que estaba bien.
I know I tried it.
Yo sé, yo lo intenté.
And it only led me to hurt.
Y solamente me llevó a lastimar.
Pain, I lost my freedom.
El dolor, perdí mi libertad.
If you know my testimony, you know.
Si conoces mi testimonio.
But I'm sure you have your own testimony.
Pero tú tienes tu testimonio.
And you know where those things take you.
Y tú sabes dónde te lleva eso.
But man, Daniel did what he had to do.
Pero Daniel hizo lo que tenía
he
que
said,
hacer.
Let me tell you about the story.
Dice, te voy a contar sobre esto.
Just to refresh you.
Para refrescarte.
They put up a committee of leaders.
Pusieron un comité de líderes.
And Daniel had this man, because he prayed, he had this kind of favor over his life.
Y Daniel tenía tanto favor sobre su vida.
Daniel would walk into the room.
Él caminaba al cuarto.
And there was a light that would shine.
Y había una luz que brillaba.
He would walk into a room where there was people who worshipped other gods, who were more interested in money and provisions, who were more interested in eating the finest food and having women, who were more interested in having power and authority. But the moment that Daniel stepped in the room, there was a light.
Había una luz.
And God would give him favor.
Y Dios le daba favor.
And somebody started hating on him.
Y alguien empezó a odiarlo.
And there was those that were on his level.
Y esos que estaban a su nivel.
When King Cyrus said, man, I'm going to raise you up and these guys as well.
Como el rey Cyrus lo levantó, lo dice, me voy a levantar.
They looked at Daniel with like an envy.
Y miraron a Daniel con envidia.
But all Daniel did was pray.
Pero solamente lo que hizo es orar.
And so the situation got a little bit rough for him.
So la situación se puso dura para él.
But let me remind you,
pero te recuerdo,
this man just stayed close to God.
Este hombre solamente se acercó a Dios.
He was favored by God.
Era favorable de
God
Dios.
Gave him wisdom.
Dios le daba sabiduría.
There was something about Daniel that these men made him uncomfortable because they wanted his position.
Había algo de Daniel que querían algo de él, que querían su posición.
Because they already had that feeling that God was going to raise him up above them.
Porque ya tenían ese sentir que Dios lo iba a levantar más allá de
they
ellos.
They envied because God was going to do something greater in Daniel's life than in their life.
Tenían envidia porque Dios lo iba a levantar y hacer algo grande en su
vida. And they couldn't deal with it.
Y no podían lidiar con
so
ello.
They said, we're going to set him up.
So vamos a decir, vamos a hacer
and so sneakily they go up to the king and they said, king,
le hicieron, rey,
I think we should put up a decree.
Creo que vamos a hacer un decreto
where nobody should worship except you.
Donde nadie puede alabar más que a esta figura.
And Daniel said, "This ain't my God."
Y dice, Daniel, este no es mi
I know the God I have to come to.
Yo sé al Dios al que me tengo
but
que
imagine
acercar.
The trouble that he was going
pero
through.
Imagínate la tribulación.
Imagine knowing that he was facing death.
Sabiendo que estaba enfrentando la muerte.
Knowing that he was facing a difficult outcome.
Que se enfrentaba a un resultado no favorable.
Saying that if I don't listen to these rules,
que
this
si no
is what could happen to me.
Escucho este decreto, lo que me va a pasar.
So what's the first thing that this man did?
Pero ¿qué es lo primero que hizo este hombre?
He went up to that room.
Entró a su cuarto.
Where he prayed three times a day.
Donde oraba tres veces al día.
And he did what he had always done.
Y hacía lo que siempre hacía.
He got on his knees.
Se puso de rodillas.
And if you look at the scripture.
Y si miras la escritura.
You can see the kind of prayers that Daniel would do.
Puedes ver las oraciones que hacía.
God, I need you.
Dios te ocupo.
I need your favor.
Por favor.
Forgive me for my sin.
Perdóname por el pecado.
Forgive me for my people.
Por el pueblo.
That they could be rebellious.
Que pueden ser, rebeldes.
And the things that were going on right then and there.
Y las cosas que estaban pasando ahí.
Rebellion.
Rebelión.
Sounds like my children.
Me parece como mis hijos.
Pastor might be looking around saying, sounds like my disciples.
Es como mis discípulos.
Rebellious soul.
Rebeldes.
Daniel did what he knew how to do.
Daniel hacía lo que sabía hacer.
He did not give up.
No se rendía.
Bible says he came to that same place, got on his knees and prayed as he always did.
Dice que llegó al mismo lugar y hizo lo que sabía hacer.
He could have done so many other things.
Podría haber hecho cualquier otra cosa.
One thing that he could have done is give in.
Algo lo que podía hacer es haberse comprometido.
Watch this. He could have done this.
Podía haber hecho esto.
He could have said, I'll pretend to do what they're asking to
do. Dice, voy a pretender hacer lo que me piden.
And compromise.
Y comprometer.
Pretend that I'm worshiping this God just so they won't hurt me.
Pretender que voy a adorar este Dios para que no me lastimen.
But when I go with sincere intentions, of course.
Con sinceridad, claro.
But when I go back to my place,
pero cuando regrese a casa,
I'll truly worship God.
Ahí sí voy a adorar a Dios.
He could have compromised. He could have gave in.
Podía haberse entregado a la
question
situación.
Tonight is, what do you do in your situation?
La pregunta es, ¿qué tú haces en esa situación?
Compromise, give in.
Comprometes.
And the truth about it is that not a lot of the times we know we're compromising.
Y la verdad es que a veces no sabemos ni que estamos comprometiendo.
When the devil comes in, he starts attacking the mind.
Cuando el diablo entra a atacar la mente.
He comes in through your marriage, through your children.
Entra en tu matrimonio, tus hijos.
Through finances, that's another big one.
O las finanzas,
he comes in and he's hitting and poking
y
at
ahí
you.
Empieza a golpear y
what is it that you do?
¿Qué es lo que hacemos?
Do we trust God?
¿Confiamos en Dios?
Do we get on our knees and pray?
¿Nos ponemos de rodillas a orar?
Or do we say, man, forget that. I'm not going to show up on a Friday night.
¿Sabes que olvídalo? No voy a ir el viernes en la
noche. I don't even got gas money for it.
Ni tengo gas para ir.
Forget that, man. I'm not going to give.
Olvida, no voy a dar.
I'm barely making it.
Apenas la estoy haciendo.
Man, I'm not going to humble myself and apologize.
No me voy a humillar y a pedir perdón.
What does this look like?
¿Cómo parezco?
Or are we going to go into our prayer closet?
¿O vamos a entrar en oración?
Are we going to come on a Friday night?
¿Vamos a venir un viernes en la
call out to God?
Clamar a Dios.
Are we going to put up on the group chat?
Vamos a poner en el chat.
Hey, Brother Jose, this is the prayer that I need for fasting.
Hey, Jose, esta es la oración que ocupo para el ayuno.
God, I need a breakthrough.
Ocupo un rompimiento.
What are we going to do?
¿Qué vamos a hacer?
What is it that you're going to do tonight?
¿Qué es lo que vas a hacer esta noche?
What are we going to do tonight?
¿Qué vamos a hacer hoy?
Tonight is prayer.
Esta noche es oración.
Why don't you stand on your feet?
Si se pueden poner de pie.
Tonight is prayer.
Esta noche es oración.
And I want to remind you of something before we get into prayer.
Y quiero recordarles antes de que entremos a la oración.
That we serve a God who is able.
Que servimos un Dios que es capaz.
I'm going to say it one more time.
Lo voy a decir una vez más.
We serve a God who is able.
Servimos un Dios que es capaz.
And because God is able.
Y porque Él es capaz.
He will go through these things.
Pasaremos esto.
But listen, church, we cannot be unshakable.
Pero no puedes ser turbado.
Daniel could have shaken in that time.
Daniel se podría haber sido turbado.
He could have compromised.
Podría haber comprometido.
Could have said, you know what, I'm going to eat the choice food.
Y decir, ¿sabes qué? Voy a comer las delicadezas del rey.
I'm just going to do whatever they're asking me to do.
Lo que me están pidiendo hacer.
I'm going to bow down to the enemy.
Voy a inclinarme al enemigo.
Because of the fear of losing my life.
Por el temor de perder mi vida.
Or the fear of this and that.
Por el temor de esto o el otro.
And we can all relate, what fear is it for
y
me and you?
Relatar, cada quien tiene sus
I
temores.
Just shared mine.
Compartí el mío.
And the things that I can go through.
Y lo que yo paso.
But what are yours?
Pero ¿cuáles son las tuyas?
And as we get into prayer, I'm going to ask you to come to the front, find your place in the back.
Quiero que encuentren su lugar, les invito aquí enfrente.
And let's just pray, knowing that there is a God who is able, bringing every petition to the Lord tonight, asking Him to move. And listen, it may not be easy, because God will not always answer on your time. But what I can assure you here tonight is that you serve a God who is able. You serve a God who is able. Not on your time, but on His time. And He will do what He told you He was going to do. Let's pray. Jesus, we thank you, Lord, in this place. Y Padre, venimos delante de ti, Señor, y te damos gracias, Señor, en esta tarde, Señor. Te pido que tu Espíritu, Señor, derrame en este lugar. Te pido, Señor, que llenes cada copa en este lugar. Te pido, Padre, en este momento que tu Espíritu se mueva con libertad, Señor, en este cuarto, en este santuario, Señor. Que hagas de tu manera, Padre, como nunca antes, Señor. Que toda petición, Señor, para esta nueva temporada, Señor, sea puesta, Señor, ante tus pies, Señor. Señor, que en esta temporada, Señor, que nos estás trayendo, Señor, en este año 2023, Señor, que tu pueblo mire tu favor, Señor. Tu misericordia, tu gracia, tu amor, Señor. Te pido, Señor, que te muevas como nunca antes, Señor. Te pido que toda petición, Señor, de corazón sincero, Padre, sea levantada en esta tarde, Señor. Te pido que tú traigas paz, Señor, en donde no hay paz, Señor. Que des las fuerzas, Señor, en toda debilidad, Padre. Señor, tu palabra dice que nunca nos dejarás o desamparás, Señor, y te pido, oro esa palabra, Señor, en existencia en esta tarde, Señor. En esta noche, Señor, que tenemos el privilegio de venir ante ti, Padre. Te pido, Señor, por cada persona en este lugar, por cada familia, esposo, esposa, padre, en este lugar, Señor. Cada hombre en el hogar, Señor, en este lugar, Señor. Te pido por cada líder, Señor, cada persona en cualquier ministerio, Señor, todo matrimonio, Padre. Nuestro ministerio de jóvenes, Señor. La generación ungida por Dios, Señor. Te pido por ellos, Señor. Te pido, Señor, que tu voluntad sea hecha sobre sus vidas, Padre. Pedimos por nuestros pastores, Señor, que les continúes dando, Señor, esa sabiduría, Padre. La gracia, Señor, para seguir lidiando, Señor, con tu pueblo, Señor, con amor y misericordia, Padre. Te pido, Señor, por tu favor sobre sus vidas, Señor, que tú vayas delante de ellos, Señor. Señor, que tu palabra y tu espíritu, Señor, sea una lámpara a sus pies, Señor. Todo matrimonio, Señor, en este lugar, joven, Señor, maduro, Señor, cualquier sea, Padre. Te pido que tú estés en el medio de todo matrimonio, Señor. Que todo matrimonio, Señor, en nuestra iglesia, Señor, te honre en una manera especial, Señor. Que nos ayudes, Señor, a entender, Señor. Que nos ayudes, Señor, a ponerte a ti antes de nada, Señor. Antes de que uno haya al otro, Padre. Que tú seas primero en nuestras vidas, Señor. Que tú bendigas, Señor, todo matrimonio, Señor, en la casa en esta noche, Señor. Si hay matrimonio en discordia, Padre, te pido, Señor, tu favor, tu paz sobre ellos, Señor. Si hay dolor en el pasado, Señor, que fue causado, Señor, por desrespeto, Padre, o cualquier cosa, Señor, te pido por sanidad de los corazones en esta noche, Señor. Te pido, Señor, que sigas levantando a matrimonios, Señor, con integridad, que quieran hacer las cosas en la manera correcta, Señor. Te pido, Señor, por ellos que están en angustia en esta tarde, que piden por tu favor, Señor, o que piden, Señor, por tu protección, tu mano sobre sus vidas. Te pido, Padre, que sigas moviendo, Señor. Te pido, Señor, que toda petición en este lugar, Señor, que inclines tu oído, Padre, que escuches tu oración, toda petición, Señor. En el nombre de Jesús. Thank you. Oh, we thank you, Jesus.
Te damos gracias, Jesús.
I believe the Spirit of God wants to do a little bit more.
Creo que el Espíritu de Dios quiere hacer un poquito más.
I just want you to stand there for a second. Hear me out.
Quiero que se estén ahí quietos.
Hallelujah. Just stand still for a second.
Quédense quietos un momento.
Peace be with you.
Que la paz esté con ustedes.
Focus on the presence of God.
Enfóquense en la presencia de Dios.
And let God's peace fall upon you.
Deja que la paz sobreabunde sobre
I don't know
ustedes.
About you, but I need God's peace.
Yo no sé ustedes, pero yo ocupo la paz de
Most
Dios.
Of the time, it's the peace of God that I need.
Es la paz de Dios que yo ocupo.
If not every time, it's
si no
the peace
siempre.
Of God. So let's just let the piano play softly and
so deja que el pianista toque suavemente.
Let's sit there in silence and just allow the peace of God.
Estar ahí en silencio y permitir que la paz de Dios.
You see, for Daniel, it was all about trusting God.
Para Daniel era solamente confiar en Dios.
And in verse 23, this is what it says.
En versículo 23 es lo que dice.
It says, and when Daniel was lifted up from the den,
dice, cuando Daniel fue levantado,
no wounds were found on him.
No tenía heridas alguna.
And watch this right here. Because he had trusted in his God.
Porque había confiado en su Dios.
It was because Daniel had trusted in God.
Era porque Daniel había confiado en Dios.
When everything and everybody was against him.
Cuando todos estaban en contra de él.
That was the reason why.
Pero esa era la razón.
The favor of God.
El favor de Dios.
His power.
El poder.
His miracle working power.
Su poder que hace milagros.
Was over his life. And you know what happened?
¿Sabes lo que pasó?
People became believers because of it.
La gente se volvió creyentes por causa de él.
And Daniel had some kind of unspeakable favor.
Daniel tenía un favor que no se podía explicar.
And all he had to do was trust God.
Todo lo que tenía que hacer es confiar en Dios.
And so I want you to stand if you're not already standing. I want to pray for you.
Quiero orar por ustedes.
But as you come forward,
pero mientras vienen,
I just want you to have these words in your heart and in your mind.
Quiero que tengan estas palabras en su corazón.
I trust you.
Yo confío en ti.
I trust you.
Yo confío en ti.
God, I trust you.
Dios, yo confío en ti.
I trust you.
Yo confío en
Come
ti.
On, I want you to make your way forward.
Quiero que vengan aquí hacia adelante.
I trust you.
Yo confío en ti.
Come on, say it out loud, church.
Díganlo audiblemente.
I trust you.
Yo confío en ti.
I trust you.
Yo confío en
I
ti.
I trust you.
Yo confío.
I trust you.
Yo confío en ti.
I trust you. I trust you, I trust you, I trust you.
Yo confío, yo confío, yo confío en ti.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
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 Padre, te damos gracias, Señor, en este lugar. Y te pido, Señor, que selles esta palabra en nuestros corazones, Señor. Que, Señor, que empieces a sanar corazones, Señor. Mentes, y que nos ayudes, Padre, a confiar en ti. En toda tribulación, Padre, no importe, Señor, la circunstancia, Señor, que como Daniel, Señor, aprendamos, Señor, a entrar a ese cuarto, Señor, donde podamos doblar rodilla, Padre, y venir delante de ti, Señor. Te damos gracias en el nombre de Jesús. Amén, amén y amén. Hay que darle un fuerte, pero fuerte aplauso al Señor. Iglesia, les doy muchas gracias por el privilegio.
Thank you, church, for giving me the privilege.
Espero que con una canción los vamos a despedir y que tengan una noche bendecida.
And with one last song, you guys can consider yourselves dismissed.